Hello students, good morning. In today's class, we'll start about the vegetative propagation. What is vegetative propagation? In yesterday's class, we have studied about the what is asexual reproduction, and in our sexual reproduction, we have studied about the that is asexual reproductive structures. Asexual reproductive structures, that is zoospores. Then what we studied? Zoospores. Then budding. Okay, so different concepts we have studied about in yesterday's class. In today's class, we'll study about vegetative propagation. It is a type of asexual reproduction we are going to find in higher plants. Higher plants like the angiosperms. Okay, these are all angiosperms. Potato, ginger, Agaveobromophyllum, water hyacinth. Okay, so in today's class, we'll study about what is vegetative propagation. Okay, vegetative propagation. So students, please take down the points related to the vegetative propagation. What is vegetative propagation means? Higher plants like angiosperms, they can reproduce asexually by a process, by a special structure called vegetative propagules. Okay, well, but in simple term, I will tell you what is mean by vegetative propagation in simple language. Okay, please take down. I will tell you very slowly. Okay, what is vegetative propagation? Vegetative propagation is a type of asexual reproduction where a plant can reproduce asexually by a special structures called vegetative propagules. These are called as a part of the plant. Okay, with the help of its own part of the plant, with the help of its own part, plant can reproduce asexually a new plant. Okay, plant can reproduce asexually a new plant, and that process we call it as vegetative propagation. Okay, and in vegetative propagation, how vegetative propagation takes place means vegetative propagation takes place by a special structures, and those structures we call it as vegetative propagules. Vegetative propagules are the structures present in higher plants like angiosperms. Those structures helpful for the plants like potato, ginger, Agaveobromophyllum, water hyacinth, sugarcane, banana, dahlia. So these all plants, in all these plants, these vegetative propagules may arise. Okay, may arise, and from that arisen part, new plant will grow, and that type of process we call it as vegetative propagation. So student, please note down the definition of vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation is a type of asexual reproduction where a plant, okay, where a plant means angiosperms. Angiosperms, plants like potato, ginger, Agaveobromophyllum, water hyacinth, they use the vegetative part. Vegetative part means what? Vegetative propagules. They use their vegetative propagules and they reproduce a new plant, and that process we call it as vegetative propagation. Once again, take down the definition of vegetative reproduction or vegetative propagation. Vegetative reproduction or vegetative propagation, it is the same term. In vegetative propagation, a particular angiosperm plant, it can reproduce asexually a new plant. The plant can reproduce a new plant asexually by its own structures or vegetative part. This technique, this definition we call it as vegetative propagation. Correct definition of vegetative propagation is angiosperm plant like potato, ginger, agave, etc. These plant will use their vegetative part, that is vegetative propagules. With the help of vegetative propagules, they produce a new plant, and that process we call it as vegetative propagation. In vegetative propagation, we find different structures in different plants. So students, let us study the different structures. Here we have potato. Okay, potato is the plant, angiosperm plant. In potato, we'll find potato tuber. Okay, here we'll find potato tuber. Here in potato, we'll find in the potato tuber, we'll find here. So these potato tubers, okay, from potato tuber will grow, and later this tuber grow into new potato. So this we call it as vegetative propagules. The units of vegetative propagules of these plants are called as the vegetative propagules. The units of vegetative propagation are called vegetative propagules. So you may have a doubt that like that. You may have one question, that is, sir, what do you mean by vegetative propagules? Vegetative propagules are the structures of vegetative propagation. The units of vegetative propagation, we called them as vegetative propagules. Okay, now we'll study about the different vegetative propagules. Potato has potato tuber or eyes as a vegetative propagation or vegetative structure. Okay, next up, ginger, it has rhizome with the help of rhizome. Okay, next we'll study the ginger. So this is ginger. Okay, imagine this ginger, it has a rhizome like root like structures. Okay, here root like structures, the rhizome, it helps in the vegetative propagation. Next, agave bulbil. Okay, so bulbil, this is bulbil plant like this. So it has a, this is a bulbil plant, it has a agave. Okay, yeah, agave in bulbil plant, in agave plant we have bulbil is a structure which helps in the vegetative propagation. Next we have leaf buds in a bryophyllum. Okay, next to that we have leaf buds in a bryophyllum. So this is a bryophyllum leaf. In leaf we have the structures like this. Okay, so these leaf buds are called as vegetative propagules of bryophyllum. Next to that we have offset of water hyacinth. So you already, you may know that water hyacinth structure. Okay, so in root like structures we can find at the base of the water hyacinth, those are called as offset, and offsets are the vegetative propagules of the particular plant water hyacinth. And this is about the vegetative propagation. Got it? So you may get the question with related to this vegetative propagation. The question for 2 marks, write down the vegetative propagules of the following plants. Okay, write down the vegetative propagules of the following plant. This question may be asked, okay, with related to the vegetative propagation. So students, take down the question for 2 marks, write down the or they will ask what are the vegetative propagules of the following plants. Propagules of the following plants. Like this, the question may be asked. Okay, the following class plants, it may be the potato. Okay, it may be potato or agave. Okay, or water hyacinth. Water, it may be water hyacinth. So whatever it may be, question may be asked, etc. So this is a 2 marks question, very important question, students. What are the vegetative propagules of the following plants? You have to write the question like answer like this. One side you write down the plant name, and after that you write down the vegetative propagules of the particular plants. Okay, so this is related to the vegetative propagation. Time for the
art.
Good news, sir. So this is about the vegetative propagation. Okay, next we have, next we'll study about the special plant, that is water hyacinth. Water hyacinth. The another name for water hyacinth is Terror of Bengal. Terror of Bengal. Okay, so water hyacinth, or it is a weed we are going to find in standing or stagnant water. It is also called as Terror of Bengal because it drains. It is also called as oxygen scavenger. Oxygen scavenger because it drains oxygen from the standing water. It drains oxygen from the standing water. Standing water. Okay, hence it is called as Terror of Bengal. Okay, the question will be asked like this. Name the plant which is called as Terror of Bengal. The very important question related to this plant. Name the plant which is called as Terror of Bengal. We have to write the answer like this. It called, water hyacinth is called as Terror of Bengal because it drains oxygen from the standing water, and it leads to the death of, it leads to the death of, and it leads to the death of the aquatic plants and animals, aquatic plants and animals, and it leads to the death of aquatic plants and animals. Okay, it will grow wherever there is standing water, and it is a good indicator of pollution. It's a good indicator of pollution because it grows wherever there is polluted water is there or dirty water there. It grows at enormous rate. It will spread all over the body very fast, and it will make the water body as a oxygenless water body because it drains all the oxygens, all the water from the water body, and it grows at enormous rate, and it is very difficult to get rid of from the water hyacinth plant. That is also called as okay terror of Bengal.
Okay,
so this is about the what we call as vegetative reproduction.